where the king's signet ring. You ought to give him the king's scepter, and you ought to put him on the king's horn, and you ought to have him paraded down the middle of the street so everybody in the kingdom could see how great that this man is and how the king loves him, because he did a good deed towards the king, and now the king was rewarding him. And then here's where he gets gutted. Here's where the wind gets knocked out of him. This is the beginning of his end. And then the king said, well, I want you to do that for Mordecai. You did satinery, you sold discord, you went and did it the wrong way, not do it for him. He said, I want you to do it. You get up there and pull the horse. Now you got to do this in front of the same ones you went to and told that stuff to. But you do it. And the Bible said that he got there, and when he found out that, he goes back. Come on, somebody. Because he thought, you know, before this, the Bible said when the king called him, he thought it was him. So he went home and told his family, you know, his little crazy wife. She was crazy. Come on. Listen to what she said. He tells her, look, the king is getting ready to do this and do that. And she said, okay, well, look, since the king is getting ready to do this for you, because that old stanky Mordecai, he's supposed to be saved. He's supposed to be this and that. But because he went down, now this is your chance to show him who you really are. And so you know what they did? You know what the Bible said? The Bible said, then one of them told him, said, you know what? Go on and build a 50 cubits high gallows for him. Yes. And said, when you in full power, you want to kill him and have all the other folk killed. Come on, somebody. But when he had to parade him down the street, could you imagine that now? You done laid all night. You done planned your plan. You done planned to strategize. And you done said, this is right. It's funny how people will call what's wrong right and what's right wrong. And then when you own it, see, one thing worse than not doing the right thing is being misinformed. See, you got to know every step. Come on, somebody. Because if you don't know every step to the process, you're going to leave something vital out. That ain't that, and then you run and jump on board. We'll run and jump on board with mess and not know the whole story. And somebody said there's three sides, my side, your side. In the truth, I can't get no help here. Amen. And so when they did that, they tell us they build the gallows. And then when he had to address Mordecai and bring him down the street, and Mordecai was humble, but he was saved. And Mordecai had stood under the fire, but he was saved. And Mordecai had looked at him, talked about him in the city, and spread his name all around the community, and saying that Mordecai, he ain't no good because he won't bow. But Mordecai was saved. Mordecai said, I love him anyhow. Y'all quiet now. He said, I love him anyhow. Mordecai was saved. In spite of what he knew, Mordecai was saved. Look at somebody, say, stay saved under fire. Say, if you stay saved under fire, you'll be stronger when the fire burn out. I can't get no help here. Somebody give him praise right there. The Bible said that his wife told him that. But when he comes back, Brother Golden, the Bible said he came back after he had to parade Mordecai down the street. And the Bible said, then his wife, now she was the one that was pushing him. She was the one that was saying it. Then he said, then his wife said, wait a minute. You mean to tell me that you wasn't the one the king was really talking about?
All right.
No.
You mean to tell me that you were not the one who was supposed to get the ring?
No.
You weren't the one that was supposed to sit on the horse?
No.
It wasn't you?
No.
We followed you this far and it wasn't you?
No.
Oh, and then look how they turn up. Oh. Somebody said, oh. He said, well, you know what? If he's one of the Jews, if he's saved, if he's sanctified, oh, let me give it to you like this. In the New Testament said, he said, if it's not of God, he said, it'll come to naught. He said, but if it is of God, you cannot overthrow it. And I don't care what Haman did. I don't care who he got behind him. He couldn't overthrow Mordecai, because if God be for you, who can be against you? I wish somebody would praise the Lord. They say, the Lord is for me. I'm trying to help